today, Guam, and throughout the world. Now, our island may still be in P-Corps 1, but thankfully, that's not all we're talking about on this trend spotting. The police were busy this week, and we also kick-started into the holiday season. I'm Tyler Mazzanani, and here's your trend spotting report. The Guam Police Department was busy this week with a pair of grim findings. Not one, but two sets of skeletal remains were found in two different parts of the island. On Monday, what appeared to be a human skull was found along the shoreline in Hagatnya by LA Tires. A photo of the skull revealed it was nestled in sand and dirt with dried vegetation strewed on top of it and around it. An investigation has been launched and police are waiting for DNA tests by the medical examiner to return. And on Wednesday, skeletal remains were found just a village away from Monday's findings. A ground maintenance worker discovered the remains by a jungle line in Maina by the Navy substation. GPD's Criminal Investigation Division retrieved the remains and delivered them to the Chief Medical Examiner's Office for examination. And sticking with police, two men were arrested after a video of a dog being shot in Harmon went viral. 24-year-old Damian Kaleo Greer was the man identified as the alleged shooter. He was arrested for cruelty to an animal. Also arrested was 34-year-old Jesse Pua Villagomez Jr., who recorded the event. Police charged him with guilt established by complicity. Before the arrest, Guam Animals in Need offered a $1,000 reward for the arrest and conviction of the person responsible. Gain was able to locate the dog, which appeared injured. Let's take a look at some comments. Nicholas Tyskin says, hold government accountable for failure to remove stray dog population. Promotes unsanitary conditions, i.e. your neighbor's trash, diapers, ringworm, etc. and possible life at risk from mauling attacks. Shiro Longorian says, they'll probably get off with a warning. No one has been convicted yet of animal cruelty because there's loopholes in the law. And Rita Guerrero simply put, fine and in prison for animal cruelty. Now, let's take a sharp turn into the holiday season. This week, you helped KUAM kick it off with Giving Tuesday. It's one of our biggest annual community service initiatives where we invite the island to help out on the Global Day of Giving. On Tuesday, many island residents strolled by the KUAM studios in Harmon for our donation drive-thru. You delivered toys and non-perishable foods in support of the Salvation Army's food bank and holiday toy distribution program. Even our island's top leaders, Governor Lou Leon Guerrero and Lieutenant Governor Josh Tenorio, made time to give their donations.
So these are on my birthday. Friends and family donated non-perishable goods, and so I decided that I would donate it also. And some of these are also coming from, you know, our cabinet members, our employees, and so forth. So we would like to just say from our generosity, I hope it helps, and I hope it lifts somebody in some way. So thank you again, KUAM Care Force, for this wonderful event today.
And our KUAM Care Force kept on going. With the help of sponsors, we were able to drop off personal protective equipment and other supplies, as well as pizza, to our hardworking frontliners at our public health, GMH, and GRMC. We also made a stop at St. Dominic's to drop off some supplies for the staff at the elderly care facility. Benita Jones wrote, thank you KUAM and all the other sponsoring companies for this whole Giving Tuesday. We at GRMC truly appreciate the donations today. And Kenneth Paulino said, awesome job. Thanks guys. We've got a few ways to safely share the holidays with us at KUAM, and it starts with making spirits bright. This is your opportunity to send and share your photos of your Christmas and holiday decorations, and we'll feature it over the weekends. Send those pics by direct message on our Facebook or Instagram pages. And this one's for the kids. Letters to Santa. Log your little one onto KUAM.com where they write to the big man himself and receive a response from the North Pole. And as a bonus, Santa will be speaking with a few lucky kids over Zoom on December 19th.
And on Giving Tuesday, we could not do it each year without your support and the generosity of our island businesses. So thank you so much again. Until next week, adjust.